So, we're coming already to the end of week one of Devtoberfest. It's started. The month-long celebration, annual celebration, of what makes us developers. It's a learn fest. Great sessions, even better participation from you lot. So, yeah, we've got three more weeks to go. Some of the great sessions this week, I just want to highlight. We had Martin Stensig on Monday, showing us how we can make SAP extensibility a reality with SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, all in 60 minutes. We had Vanessa Michelli-Schmidt show us how to get started with low-code, no-code development. We've had some great sessions on the topic of integration, on graph, on event management, and event-driven architecture, and also API management. Under a tree, this is a low tree. We've also had Klaus-Peter Zauer show us all about SAP Datasphere. And last but certainly not least, on Friday, one of the highlights for me was the inimitable Volker Buzek with lots of new features for VDI 5. It's not too late to get started with Devtoberfest and start earning points. So head on over to Tom Young's blog post to find out how. See you on the SAP community.
In this segment, I'm going to call You May Have Missed. In April of this year, you may have missed a great blog post from Alper de Dalieu. Alper documents his journey along with Martin Frick on comparing how to develop an application on SAP BTP Cloud Foundry Runtime and SAP BTP Kima Runtime. After explaining at a high level what the Kima and Cloud Foundry Runtimes are, Alper then shows us how to containerize an application and integrate it with the involved frameworks. In the next sections, you'll dive into service management and consumption, extensibility, service mesh, multi-tenancy. There's so much more as well. So please, if you're looking to brush up on the differences between these two runtimes, if you just want to experiment and build an application and practice your skills with both runtimes, please give this blog post and all the associated content a really good look. Let us know in the comments any questions you have or feedback on what your experience was like.
Hi, everyone. We developers know how important it is to maintain clean code to achieve the best possible results from our software developments. You might have already seen the previous blog post by Olga, how to enable clean code checks for ABAP, focusing on CodePal. In her recent blog post, she explains that now there is a free and open source version of CodePal for ABAP cloud checks, which is of course cloud enabled, hence can be executed in SAP BTP ABAP environment and is also remote enabled. Additionally, it provides quick fixes to automate and thus speed up the adaptation to clean ABAP. In this blog post, she points out some of the technical prerequisites, the detailed steps to install CodePal for ABAP Cloud Checks via ABAP Git, how to execute CodePal for ABAP Cloud Checks, as well as how to use quick fixes in an automated way. So, check out this blog post for more information and start implementing clean code in your ABAP Cloud developments. Thank you.
Are you curious about the path to unleashing your developer potential? Well, you've come to the right place, where ideas get real. A very warm welcome to those of you joining the application development and automation track at TechEd 2023. Our track is a great fit for you if you're interested in building apps, automating processes, and improving business sites. We offer a wide spectrum of options from pro code to no code. You learn how to use generative AI and pre-built templates that redefine the way you create enterprise solutions. Just imagine, whether you're a business user or a developer, you now have the power to develop and extend your applications without any limits. Learn to innovate more productively while remaining secure and scalable. Master the art of working in fusion development teams and foster innovation with great governance practices. And at last, gain experience in enterprise automation and speed up your journey to an autonomous enterprise. Ready to unleash your potential? Join me and SAP experts at TechEd, where ideas get real. Register today and see you in November.
So, the September edition of the SAP Business Application Studio is now out with lots of improvements and new features. These are all described very nicely in Birgit Selbach's blog post. For example, the software as a service application subscription processes have been improved. And one of the improvements is basically automatic creation and mapping of routes. In another innovation, we have SAP Business One as a new system that's now available in the service center, meaning you can discover and start to consume services from these systems in your databases. And last but not least, goodbye project page, hello storyboard page. This storyboard is now the start page for your databases, and it's great. It contains a graphical representation of all your application components. Check out Birgit's blog post for all the details and lots more.